Mentor once again. What's up, 23% Nation? This is your man, Coach D. Today, I'm back with Mentor Mondays. Basically, this video series is where we discuss everything related to mentors. Now, for today, I do have five objectives that I'd like to accomplish. Number one, I want to define what a mentor is. Number two, I want to offer you three of Coach D's tips. Number three, I want to state who my mentor is. Number four, I want to share a quote from my mentor. And number five, I want to let you know three reasons why I either agree or disagree with whatever my mentor is currently talking about. So let's go ahead and dive just a little deeper. Ladies and gentlemen, for today, we're going to say that a mentor is defined as someone who gives help and advice over an extended period of time. Now, this mentor could be your boss, it could be your supervisor, your teacher, your professor, or maybe even your pastor. Now, there are four very quick tips that I'd like to offer you as far as mentorship is concerned. So, tip number one from Coach D is to have more than one mentor. That's right, guys. I firmly believe that everybody should have health mentors, wealth mentors, and relationship mentors. Tip number two, find yourself a physical mentor, meaning someone that you can actually sit down with across from a table or maybe now online, right? And have a eye-to-eye, heart-to-heart conversation with them. Or number three, find yourself a virtual mentor. Now, this is a type of mentor that's online. They're on the internet. So maybe they have their own YouTube channel. Maybe they have their own blog, or maybe they have their own podcast. Tip number four. Now, this is for a lot of younger people who swear up and down that their friends and their family members are their mentors. Well, you gotta rethink something. Is that a mentor is supposed to directly help you accomplish things that you're looking to do in the future, or maybe even the immediate future, right? So use your friends and family only if they are doing exactly what it is you want to do in your near or distant future. Now, for today's video, I got to share with you one of my all-time favorite mentors, and his name happens to be the one and only Jim Rohn. That's right, ladies and gentlemen, 23% Nation. His name is Jim Rohn. Now, here are really some few things that we really need to know about Mr. Rohn. Number one, he's an entrepreneur. Actually, his real name is Emmanuel James Rohn. Interesting, huh? Also, he's an author. He's a motivational speaker. I listen to him all the time. He was born September 17th, 1930. And unfortunately, he's already passed away. And that happened back on December 5th of 2009. And here's a really fun fact, is that Tony Robbins, yes, the one and only Tony Robbins, actually claims that Jim Rohn is one of his mentors. So why not learn from someone who Tony Robbins claims is his mentor, right? Now, the quote that I want to share with you from Jim Rohn is this, and I'll say it twice. Demand integrity from yourself. I'll say it again. Jim Rohn says, demand integrity from yourself. Now, for today's video, I want to very quickly define what the term integrity means. It is the quality of being honest and having strong moral principles. Now, another way that we can term that is the state of being whole and undivided. Interesting, huh? Now, I want to offer you three reasons why I either agree or disagree with my mentor. Now, of course, I agree with demanding more of yourself, particularly integrity, right? So really what I want to offer you are three ways in which we can incorporate a little more integrity in our lives. So, more of Coach D's tips. Tip number one. Keep your word. In other words, do what you say you're going to do. Now the question is, what does that mean? How do I do that? Well, guys, let me put it to you this way. Make sure your yes means yes. Also, make sure your no means no. Also, learn to be on time. And if you're not going to be on time, then simply let people know that you're going to be a little late. Tip number two, stay focused. In other words, avoid distractions. Very, very important. So how do we do this? Well, we have to watch out for people and things that eat away our time. I call those time and energy vampires. Also, create a schedule and don't be afraid to stick to your schedule. And tip number three, surround yourself with people you feel have a lot of integrity. So, maybe you're a college student, which means you probably want to hang around those college students who get a lot of A's, right? Also, if you are an employee, you may want to spend your time around people who are in a higher position than you currently are. Maybe you are an employer, which means you may want to embrace those employees who do more than what they get paid for. Well, believe it or not, guys, that's all that I have for you today. Always remember, let's eat well, feel well, think well, do well, be well. This is your man, Coach D. I'm signing out. Always remember to take care, God bless, and never, ever forget that Coach D loves you.